Welcome to another session of CAT18 Slot 2 Questions. Basically, I'll be taking a few questions of CAT18 and look at how to approach those sums. Basically, looking at alternate methods or the right method that is required for CAT. What I normally see is people normally use equations formulae, which normally makes them slow and is not the right method. They also believe that the methods I'm doing out here is a little difficult to understand, but nothing is difficult. If you try to practice and get the approach right, I'm sure you'll be able to do this. It is not that I got this approach immediately. I have worked on it over a period of time. And I've seen students who have worked on the approach really benefiting from it. So I would recommend that try to change your approach as far as possible so that you can crack the exam. Okay, let's look at the questions. Ramesh and Ganesh can complete the work in 16 days. After 7 days of working together, Ramesh got sick and efficiency fell by 30%. So normally when you say efficiency fell by 30% for Ramesh, so the original efficiency was, ratio was 10, the new efficiency would be 7. So work done by them will be 10:7. Right? So if 10:7 is the work done, so let's say initially he used to do 10x work per day or x work per day. Now he is doing 0.7x work per day. So if you look at it, he stopped working after 7 days. That means he worked for the remaining 9 days. Okay, he didn't work for the remaining 9 days, which is 9 days of work, 9x work. Instead of that, he worked for 10 days. He worked till 17 day at 0.7x per day, which will give you 7x work. So instead of doing 9x work in 9 days, he did 7x work in 10 days. So difference is 2x work, which was done by Ganesh in 1 day. So that means Ganesh does 2x work in 1 day. That means together they complete 3x work in 1 day. 2x plus x, 3x work in 1 day. So when Ramesh stopped working after 7 days, 9 into 3, 27x work was left, which will be completed by Ganesh in 27x upon 2x, which is 13.5 days. Because every day he does 2x work, so 27x work he will do in 13.5 days. So third option. You can do this without using a x. I used x just for understanding purpose. So work is 10:7. So originally if R used to do x work, then now he does 0.7 work. So 9 days of work he did not do 9x. Instead of that, he worked for 10 days at 0.7x. 7x. So the rest 2x work was done by Ganesh in 1 day, because they worked for 16 days originally. Now Ganesh worked 1 extra day, 17 days. So that was done by Ganesh in 1 day. So Ganesh does 2x work in 1 day. So together they should work, originally they should do 3x work, which is 2x plus x in 1 day. So 9 days, that is after he left, 9 days of work was left, that is 27x work was left, which he completed 13.5 days. A jar contains a mixture of 175 ml. So if you look at it, we are removing 10% every time. So initially there was 175 ml of water. You remove 10%, that means you are removing 17.5. When water also goes 10%, when you are removing 10%, 10% of water and 10% of alcohol is gone. And then you substitute back in water. That means the total is 875. So you are putting 10% water, 875 you are replacing back. So total left is 245. Again you are removing 10% of water and adding 875. 10% of 875. So if you look at, you're adding 63, which comes to 308. So now we have 308 liters of water out of 875. If you calculate approximately also, you can be able to get the answer is 35.2. So you can make out 875, 10% will be 87.5, 30% will be around 240, 250 around. So 308 is much more than 30%. So you can make out the answer will be 35.2. You can do approximate calculations wherever the options are far. The score of Amal and Bimal in the examination is 11:14. And it becomes 47:56 later. We want a ratio of Bimal's new score to the original score. So you're adding equal number of marks in both the places. This is a common sum that normally is asked in banking exam, where you add few things on both the side and you get a new ratio. The way to solve this is, look at difference. 11 and 14 difference is 3. 47 and 56 difference is 9. Normally when you add same values for both the side, the difference should remain the same. So to make the difference same, you have to multiply 3 into 3. So automatically this becomes 33 and 42. After multiplying by 3. So you will multiply everything by 3. So Bimal's new score to original score will become 4:3. 56. So new score is 56. Original score is 42. 4:3. kilometer apart. So if you look at it properly, they're traveling throughout at the same speed. So what will differentiate them is the time. The time will remain the same between the two. If you understand the sum properly, and that's what's important, you will realize time will remain the same. Then you can solve immediately. So initially 20 kilometer apart from A, he is 20 kilometer apart from A and he's traveling at 100 kilometers per hour. So how much time did he start early? Time is equal to distance upon speed, which is 20 upon 100, 1/5 of hour. So he traveled 1/5 of the hour early. So automatically car 2 will reach 1/5 of an hour late, I mean finished. So 1/5 of 25 kilometers per hour, remember that. Distance is equal to speed into time. Time is 1/5 hour, speed is 25 kilometers per hour, the answer will be 5 kilometers. So if he starts 1/5 hour late, he will reach 1/5 hour. So he'll be 1/5 hour behind, which comes to 1/5 of 25 kilometers per hour, 5 kilometers. Here you're mixing A and B. Initially A and B is 18:7. If it's 18:7, and you're mixing in a ratio of 3:4. So just to make this a multiple of 3, right now this is 18+7=25. Just to make it a multiple of 3, because I'm mixing it 3, I'm multiplying by 3. So what you get is 54:21, which becomes 75 total. If this is 75, 54:21 is 75, 4 will be 100. Next mixture you'll add is 100 to give you 175. Actually, I can make out, because this total is 100, the total of both the values should be somewhere around 100. So if you add it up, this total becomes 370. This total becomes 369, not possible. This becomes 400 and this becomes total something 4147. Only third sum looks like the possible answer 400. You can substitute, get the answer, or directly mark third option. You can make out. Or there is also not a difficult way of doing it. So this 175 is basically nothing but they are given 13:7. 13:7 is 20. 20 into 8.75 gives you 175. 28 is 160 and 0.75, 175. So 7 into 0.875, 8.75. Multiply this. You should get 61.25. You can use a calci if you want. I mean, there is, if you can do it without calci, great. So if this is 61.25, this is 21. What do you get? Balance is 40.25. That is for B. If out of 100, 40.25 is B, A will be the remaining, which is 59.75. So to find the actual ratio, you can multiply by 4. When you multiply by 4, you get the value as 239:161, which is third option. I hope this is clear. Just to explain you some methods of solving, try it out. You may require to understand a little bit fundamentals to get into it, but once you get the methods right, you can be really fast. and that is what is required to crack the CAT. Learning these methods are not difficult. I've seen people, like average people who had scored 44% in the exam, being able to learn these methods. It's only thing you have to try it out. Thank you.